وهل أتاك حديث موسى إذ رأى نارا فقال لأهلهم كثوا إني آنست نارا لعلي آتيكم منها بقبس أو أجد على النار هدى.
بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وبعد. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وجعلني وزيرا من أهلي هارون أخي أشدد به أزري وأشركه في أمري كي نسبحك كثيرا ونذكرك كثيرا إنك كنت بنا بصيرا. صدق الله العظيم. So we were discussing the prayer, supplication and request of Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wassalam before proceeding to Pharaoh to give him the da'wah. And we somewhat covered the wisdom in the selection of his different du'as. And then we touched on his request to Allah to send his brother Harun, who was more articulate. And also that in Tafsir al-Mazhari, it is mentioned that Harun alayhi salam is referred to as Hibatullah, as a gift given to Musa alayhi salam on his request. Ushdud bihi azri wa ashrikhu fi amri, verse 31 and 32. That, O Allah, strengthen me with him. Empower me with him. There can be no two opinions. If a person is alone, it's so much more challenging. There's so much more fears. But when you have company with you, when you have someone to walk alongside with you, give you strength, courage, etc. And again, we look at the institution of marriage that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his wisdom has made for us a partner, someone with whom we can share our happiness, our sadness. Our father Adam, our ancestor Adam alayhi salam, could not fully benefit at optimum from Jannah, which is the pinnacle of bliss, until and unless he was not paired up with a partner, our mother Eve and Hawa alayha min Allahi as-salatu wa taslim. So a partner plays a great role, someone, a companion, an associate. When the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam lost Khadija radiyallahu anha, he was very sad. And they asked him, O Nabi of Allah, what makes you feel so sad? He said, I lost the partner of my life. And she absolutely was the most amazing, unique, outstanding spouse and consort of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Allah approved the request of Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. And Allah said, قَالَ سَنَشُدُّ عَضُدَكَ بِأَخِيكَ سَنَشُدُّ عَضُدَكَ بِأَخِيكَ وَنَجْعَلُ لَكُمَا سُلْطَانًا فَلَا يَصِلُونَ إِلَيْكُمَا بِآيَاتِنَا أَنْتُمَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَكُمَا الْغَالِبُونَ. Allah said, قَالَ سَنَشُدُّ عَضُدَكَ. Surely we will strengthen you by your brother. We will empower you by sending your brother with you. وَنَجْعَلُ لَكُمَا سُلْطَانًا. And we will give you this clout and this strength and this might and this presence. فَلَا يَصِلُونَ إِلَيْكُمَا. They will not dare touch you in any way. أَسْمَعُ وَأَرَى. أَسْمَعُ مَا يَقُولُ وَأَرَى مَا يَفْعَلُ. I am watching Pharaoh's movements and I'm listening to him. And I am protecting you and you are under my care. وَأَشْرِكْهُ فِي أَمْرِي. The 32nd verse of Surah Taha. And make him a partner to me in my task. Make him a partner to me in my task. We also learn the importance of partnership in doing activities of good. We learn the importance of doing partnership. We need to share. And unfortunately, one of the things that has paralyzed our community, in fact, let me use it on two fronts. A, when we have a setback in our life, when we have a challenge and a snag, then our community is rocked and plagued by the blame game. It's because of them, it's because of this one, it's because of that, it's because of management, it's because of staff, it's because of those in this department of deen. So we kind of give off this self-nobility and we point fingers to everyone. فَأَقْبَلَ بَعْضُهُمْ عَلَى بَعْضٍ يَتَلَاوَمُونَ. And the hadith teaches us that when we appear before Allah on the day of Qiyamah, if we find good recorded in our book of deeds. And may Allah make us amongst those people. طُوبَى لِمَنْ وَجَدَ فِي صَحِيفَتِهِ إِسْتِغْفَارًا كَثِيرًا فَمَنْ وَجَدَ خَيْرًا فَلْيَحْمَدِ اللَّهِ. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, if you appear before Allah, when you do, because we have to appear, وَكُلَّ إِنسَانٍ أَلْزَمْنَاهُ طَائِرَهُ فِي عُنُقِهِ, and every person will have his fate and destiny and his book dangling around his neck. وَنُخْرِجُ لَهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ كِتَابًا, a book will be presented. يَلْقَاهُ مَنْشُورًا, he will find it open. اِقْرَأْ كِتَابَكَ, read your book and your record. كَفَى بِنَفْسِكَ الْيَوْمَ عَلَيْكَ حَسِيبًا, today you can decide yourself because you authored this book. This is your own records. This is your own deeds, whatever. أَضَلَمَكَ كَتَبَتِي الْحَافِظُونَ. The hadith wherein the Prophet ﷺ says that Allah will ask the servant, have my angels oppressed you in recording something which you have not committed? And know, O Allah, whatever we've done, it is recorded here. In the 15 juz in Surah Kahf, وَوَجَدُوا مَا عَمِلُوا حَاضِرًا, وَوَجَدُوا مَا عَمِلُوا حَاضِرًا, whatever you do will be found and recorded before you. So at that time, the Prophet ﷺ said, if you find that there's good recorded for you, when you appear before Allah and you find forgiveness and pardon and Jannah, فَلْيَحْمَدِ اللَّهِ, praise Allah, praise Allah, don't take credit, praise Allah. وَمَنْ وَجَدَ غَيْرَ ذَلِكَ, and if you appear before Allah and you find that there isn't a good record for you, and unfortunately it is a time in hell or there's consequences, etc., فَلَا يَلُومَنَّ إِلَّا نَفْسَ, then don't blame anyone but yourself. Don't blame anyone but yourself. As long as we point fingers, we don't make progress. We are the architects of our destiny in the sense that we choose to go the way we want. Allah has given us the right of choice. Allah says this in the Quran. فَأَمَّا مَنْ أَعْطَى وَاتَّقَى وَصَدَّقَ بِالْحُسْنَى فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْيُسْرَى وَأَمَّا مَنْ بَخِلْ وَاسْتَغْنَى وَكَذَّبَ بِالْحُسْنَى فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْعُسْرَى. فَأَمَّا مَنْ أَعْطَى, the one who's generous, فَأَمَّا مَنْ أَعْطَى, he gives, فَأَمَّا مَنْ أَعْطَى وَاتَّقَى, and he fears Allah, وَصَدَّقَ بِالْحُسْنَى, and he affirms the truth, then we help him to go further in virtue for that which he opted for. وَأَمَّا مَنْ بَخِلْ, and the one who withholds, وَاسْتَغْنَى, and perceives himself to be self-sufficient, وَكَذَّبَ بِالْحُسْنَى, and belies the truth, فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْعُسْرَى, then we leave him to walk deeper onto the path that he opted for. وَيَزِيدُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ اهْتَدَوْا هُدَى, and Allah increases the guided ones in guidance. قُلْ مَنْ كَانَ فِي الضَّلَالَةِ فَلْيَمْدُدْ لَهُ الرَّحْمَنُ مَدَّى, say unto them, the one who's in deviation, Allah then extends the rope for him to go deeper into that which he has opted for. So my first message in this context here is, if you find good, praise Allah. And if there's anything wrong, be responsible. Be responsible. The buck stops here. Don't pass it on to anyone else. And then the second challenge that unfortunately has plagued our community is that we don't have a sense of mutually working together. So here Musa alayhi salam is saying, send my brother, together we present, together nusabbihaka kathira wa nadhkuraka kathira. We work together as a team. We work together as a team. By Allah, if all our institutions and organizations can only work in a way where we complement each other, we would the fate of the ummah would be far different. But unfortunately, we put in an obstacle in his path and he's put in an obstacle in my path. And there's this beautiful narration of the Muhajireen, right? That when they migrated from Mecca to Medina, and understand, they left their native land, they had to leave their own homes. It was challenging, it was difficult. It was so, you know, what the attachment to your native land is intrinsic. And then your native land being Mecca, which enhances the attachment. أَلَا هَلْ أَبِيتَنَّ لَيْلَةً بِوَادٍ وَحَوْلِي إِذْخِرٌ وَجَلِيلُ وَهَلْ أَرِدًا يَوْمًا مِيَاهَ مَجِنَّهُ وَهَلْ يَبْدُونَ لِي شَامَةٌ وَطَفِيلُ. These were the couplets of Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu anhu after migrating. أَلَّذِينَ هَاجَرُوا فِي اللَّهِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا ظُلِمُوا, those who migrated after they were exploited. أَلَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا عَلَى رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ, those who endured and they relied on Allah. لَنُبَوِّئَنَّهُمْ فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنًا, we will grant them a good abode in this world. وَلَأَجْرُ الْآخِرَةِ أَكْبَرُ, and the reward of the latter is far more supreme. So when the migrants migrated, they migrated, which was such a great and, a huge feat and a huge accomplishment. And then when they were received by the superb hospitality of the Ansar, They said to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, لَقَدْ خَشِينَا أَن يَذْهَبُوا بِالْأَجْرِ كُلِّ. Oh Prophet of Allah, it looks like our Ansari brethren are going to take all the reward and go. They're going to take all the reward and go. Because their hospitality is just amazing, unmatched, unparalleled, unprecedented, unique in all regards. And the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, no, مَا دَعُوتُمُ اللَّهَ لَهُمْ وَأَثْنَيْتُمْ عَلَيْهِمْ بِخَيْرِ. Pray for them and praise them. Make dua for them and praise them. And Allah will give you a share of their good and give them a share of your good. So compliment each other. I say they're doing great work. They say I'm doing great work. I'm saying you're doing great work. And in that way, we make the wheel turn. So we compliment and we don't contradict. If only we can extract this lesson from the request of Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, that we ought to better and advance. What did the young boy say? My grandfather told me there are two types of people. Those who seek recognition and do nothing, and those who do everything and don't seek recognition. Work for the latter, my son. There's no competition there. There's no competition. The first category is who? Those that seek recognition without doing anything. And the second category is those who toil without recognition. Join the latter. Why? Because there's no competition there. But in the first, it's flooded because everybody is seeking name, unfortunately. So Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wasalam request Allah, ashrikhu fi amri, include him in my mission. Wa ashrikhu fi kay nusabbihaka kathira wa nadhkuraka kathira, so that we can purify your name, we can glorify you, we can speak about your greatest case, so that nusabbihaka kathira. No, we can praise you in abundance, وَنَذْكُرَكَ كَثِيرًا, and we can remember you in abundance, which is the 34th verse. Again here, the scholars of tafsir say, it's not like it's impossible to remember Allah in abundance when you're alone. Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam said, oh Allah, let my brother come, so together, jointly, collectively, we will praise you, glorify you, etc. So was it not possible for Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wasalam to do that individually? Absolutely possible. There's no doubt about that. However, none can refute that if you have a colleague and an associate and a partner with you who supports you, it makes the task easier. One encourages the other. One encourages the other. One motivates the other. One inspires the other. Together, I go to sleep, you spend the night in prayer, then you come and wake me up, and I spend the night in sleep, and you spend the night in prayer. We divide the night, we divide the activity at home. In this way, there's a rotation of everybody having their needs to be fulfilled, and at the same time, someone is in the worship of the Almighty. وَنَذْكُرَكَ كَثِيرًا. So we need good companions. I often speak about the narration of Ibn Abi Dunya under الذكر في مواقع الغفلة. It appears in Hayat al-Sahaba as well. الذكر في مواقع الغفلة, that remembering Allah at the time or the venue or location where people are careless. So التقى رجلان في السوق, two people meet in a marketplace. فقال أحدهما للآخر تعال نستغفر الله في غفلة الناس. One says to the other, listen, your people are all occupied and immersed and doing this and that. Let's spare a moment and the two of us just speak about Allah. Speak about Allah. Glorify the Almighty. Speak about the Almighty. So they say that's fine. And then they both engage in the remembrance of the Almighty and they both encourage, motivate each other. And then one passes away and the other one sees him in a dream. So he says, how did you fare before Allah? He said, عَلِمْتَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ غَفَرَ لَنَا عَشِيَّةَ إِلْتَقَيْنَا فِي السُّوقِ. You know, the day, the evening, I met you in the marketplace, in the mall, and then we exchanged some kind words about speaking about the greatness of the Almighty. He says, absolutely, I have a vivid recollection. He says, because of that moment, Allah forgave me. Because of that moment, Allah forgave me. We ask Allah to accept our humble endeavors of trying to expound and do some basic commentary of this chapter of the Quran, and accept from both the speaker, the listener, and the viewer, inshallah. وَنَذْكُرَكَ كَثِيرًا إِنَّكَ كُنْتَ بِنَا بَصِيرًا. And that takes us to the 35th verse of Surah Taha, in which Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wasalam says, undoubtedly, you are ever watchful over us, Allah. You are monitoring us, you are aware of us, you know everything, O Allah, you know everything. What did Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam say? such a beautiful supplication. He says that, وَرْزُقُهُمْ مِنَ الثَّمَرَاتِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَشْكُرُونَ. Oh Allah, bless my family with fruit and provision so that they can be grateful. And then he makes multiple du'as, and then he says, رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ تَعْلَمُ مَا نُخْفِي وَمَا نُعْلِنْ وَمَا يَخْفَى عَلَى اللَّهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فِي السَّمَاءِ. Oh Allah, I supplicate you because you have told us to supplicate you, and not because you don't know what our needs are. You know it. In fact, I often say that Allah understands our needs better than what we can express it with our tongue. So when I ask Allah what I need, my tongue and my request can be deficient, but what is in my heart is known to Allah, and that probably is a clearer reflection of my request than my tongue. So Allah knows exactly what's in my heart, and Allah knows as well what I utter on my tongue. And Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam said, Rabbana innaka ta'lamu ma nukhfi wa ma nu'lin, because we don't have the correct words, choices, presentation to understand how to request Allah. We have to look at the du'as of the Anbiya alayhi salatu was salam. The very Musa alayhi salam whom we are speaking about, when he came to Madian initially and he had helped the daughters of Shu'aib alayhi salatu was salam, and then he took shelter beneath a tree and he was in an unknown land, and there was a warrant of arrest against him, and he was hungry, he had no shelter, he didn't know what the future holds, he was not yet a prophet at that time, and he made this amazing dua, right? He made this amazing dua, Rabbi inni lima anzalta ilayya min khayrin faqir. Ay Rabbi inni faqirun lima anzalta ilayya. Oh my Lord, I desperately need any form of good that you can make available to me. Wow. Oh my Lord, I desperately need any good that you can make available to me. Look at the supplication of Ayyub alayhi salam. وَنَدْعُوكَ بِمَا دَعَاكَ عَبْدُكَ Ayyub. Oh Allah, we call out to you as your servant Ayyub called out to you. Rabbi anni massani yadur. Wa anta arhamur rahimin. Allah, I'm afflicted by pain, and you the most kind. Allah, I'm afflicted by difficulty, and you are the most kind. So, respect to the will of Allah, respect to the fact that illness is also a bounty from Allah, and cure is also a bounty, without trespassing the limits, in a modest way, what a complete dua. Oh my Lord, I have been afflicted with pain and you are the most kind. My word. And what did Sayyidina Nuh alayhi salam say? Rabbi anni maghloob fantasir. Oh my Lord, I've been overpowered. You assist and you aid. And what did Sayyidina Musa say? Rabbi ghfirli wa li akhi wa adkhilna fi rahmatik. Oh Allah, pardon me and pardon my brother. Wa adkhilna fi rahmatik, and include us in your mercy. Wa anta arhamur rahimin. And you are the most kind of all those that can ever show kindness. So that kind of concludes the supplication and the request process of Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wassalam. To recap, Allah equipped him with two miracles amongst others, and then told him to go to Pharaoh and present the da'wah. And then he requested Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make his task easy for him, to untie the knot, etc., etc. Then he also had a request to the Almighty, and Allah approved his request of appointing his brother alongside with him. And we touched on the wisdoms that were incorporated in the request of Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wassalam. And that takes us to the next verse, and that's the 36th verse of Surah Taha. I hope, wish and pray that you are enjoying this amazing discussion of the Quran as I am, my brother and sister. By Allah, for me, there is nothing but nothing. I've said it to my family and I say it in my discussions. I swear by Allah, whose control is my life, nothing gives me a greater spiritual ecstasy than to read the Quran, reflect over the Quran, and just to be consumed. See, everybody gets consumed in his own field. Allah speaks about the poets. وَالشُّعَرَىٰ أَلَمْ تَرَىٰ أَنَّهُمْ فِي كُلِّ وَادٍ يَهِيمُونَ أي فِي كُلِّ وَادٍ مِّنْ أَوْدِيَةِ الشِّعْرِ يَهِيمُونَ. Don't you see the poets, their thoughts are just moving and they are floating around in the valleys of poetry. So each person is preoccupied and consumed and immersed by his passion and dream. Person who's into politics, his whole thing is politics all the time. A person who's into sports, it's this game, it's that game, it's the score, it's the finals, it's the semi-finals, it's the trophy, it's the whatever. if only our inner feelings can be activated and we can have the connection with the Quran. But alas, like Allama Busayri said, قَدْ تُنْكِرُ الْعَيْنُ ذَوْءَ الشَّمْسِ مِنْ رَمَدِي وَيُنْكِرُ الْفَمُ طَعْمَ الْمَاءِ مِنْ سَقَمِي. Sometimes when the eye is ailing, then it denies the brightness of the sun. And when a person is unwell, then he says the food is not tasty. But the truth be told, the folly is not of the food. The problem lies with your taste buds. And when our taste buds have lost its spiritual taste and connection, then I'm afraid the Quran is not a form of attraction to us. May Allah protect us. وَلَقَدْ قَالَ قَدْ أُوتِيتَ سُؤْلَكَ يَا مُوسَى قَالَ قَدْ أُوتِيتَ سُؤْلَكَ يَا مُوسَى. Wow. And Allah said, O Musa, your request has been granted, approved. Wow. You know, when humans approve, it's still not an absolute confirmation of joy. Okay, listen, it's done. Take it as done. Now the next day, you don't want to phone him because you don't want to hound him. You don't want to become, you don't want to invade him. Two, 3 days lapse, then you phone him. Listen, you promise you'll do it. Oh, forgive me. I slipped up. I just forgot about it totally. So humans can approve and they still slip out. And sometimes they approve and then they deficient in the manner in which they deliver. But you promised me, A, you delivered, B, yeah, well, actually, you know what? Subsequently, things change. I'm afraid. I'm sorry. Blah, blah, blah. قَالَ قَدْ أُوتِيتَ سُؤْلَكَ يَا مُوسَى. Musa, your request has been approved. And you know what, my brother and my sister, and I share this, and probably it would resonate with you as well. Often in life, we go through challenges and turbulence, and that's the nature of life. And then when we're going through these turbulent moments, right, the devil exploits it. And then he kind of injects these unpleasant thoughts in our mind regarding Allah. But why me? But how come? But I've prayed, I've made tahajjud, I've begged Allah. Somebody told me do this, I did that. Somebody suggested that, I did everything. And Allah forbid, we kind of somewhat harbor unpleasant thoughts. And then time moves on. And then Allah answers our du'as on the time which He knows is best for us. And now you feel so terrible about yourself and so guilty about yourself that, oh my Lord, when you answered it, which you knew what was the best time, you delivered and answered way beyond what I could imagine and dream and anticipate and request. And now you say, but how nasty of me, how evil of me, that what were the thoughts that I had harbored and wondered, only to know that Allah has granted my request in many folds greater and superior than what I had requested. And we ask Allah at this time that while we are discussing how Allah had answered the prayer of Musa alayhi salam, to all our brothers and sisters and all those that are in any pain, grief, illness, disease, poverty, rebellious children, turbulent marriages, whatever the nature may be, may Allah remove and alleviate the pain and the agony of every person. And may Allah instantly and perpetually grant us all ease and afia. وَلَقَدْ مَنَنَّا عَلَيْكَ مَرَّةً أُخْرَى. Wow, this is like my word. Oh Musa, you know what? Prayer answered, request approved, whatever you want is done, it's approved, it's concluded, it's finalized, you have it. Your brother Harun is with you, he's a prophet, your task is going to be easy, Pharaoh won't touch you, your bosom will bear the responsibility, everything's going to go, it's done, right? وَلَقَدْ مَنَنَّا عَلَيْكَ مَرَّةً أُخْرَى. Oh my Allah, oh my Lord, subhanallah, look at the beauty. And oh Musa, we favored you and blessed you many times before when you were not even aware. Today, you stand as a prophet requesting, and surely we approve your request and we will empower you and assist you. But then Allah follows up the approval of the request of Musa by saying, وَلَقَدْ, and certainly, مَنَنَّا, we have favored you, عَلَيْكَ مَرَّةً أُخْرَى, وَلَقَدْ مَنَنَّا عَلَيْكَ مَرَّةً أُخْرَى, and we had showered you with favors on many other occasions. And this now takes us into the whole discussion of how Musa alayhi salatu wasalam was born amidst the intelligence of Pharaoh and the decree of Pharaoh to butcher and to kill and to massacre children. So Allah is telling Musa alayhi salam, now you're requesting, we approve him. There was a time you were an infant, you were a baby. This was the scene around you. You were unaware, you were a child, you were a baby, you were being nursed by your mom. And وَلَهُمْ عُيُونُ الْغُرَابُ وَشَمَّةُ النَّمْلِ. Right? As Shaykh Abu al-Hasan Ali Nadwi rahimahullah writes, that the intelligence of Pharaoh, they had the smelling ability of the ant, and they had the eyes of the crow. So they were intense in their surveillance, monitoring, and locating. At that time, O Musa, at that time, O Musa, without you requesting also, these were the measures we had put in place for your protection. And what were those measures? And just a glimpse into that as we move into the discussion that follows from here onwards. You know, the poet said, and this poem gives me a shiver in my back. I was sharing it with my brother the other day, and he just teared as I was sharing it with him. The poet says, "Oh my Lord, you've been so kind to me. You've been so merciful to me. كأني بالتقصير أستوجب الفضل, that I continue in my arrogance and you continue in showering me with favors. It almost appears to me like the formula of abundance is ingratitude, is ungratefulness." In other words, that's not the reality. You need to be grateful to Allah for Allah to increase. But the way you favor me, my Lord, despite my ungratefulness, that an onlooker might assume that, oh, look at this man, he's so disobedient, he's so arrogant, yet his Lord favors him so much. So your kindness, your mercy, your grace, your clemency, your boon, your favors upon me, oh my Lord, continue. كأني as though bit taqseer, through my deficiency, and my lack of performance, astawjibul fadla, I secure and procure abundance. That's the kindness of Allah upon us. إِذْ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمِّكَ مَا يُوحَىٰ. And remember, now Allah is telling Musa alayhi salam, and this is how the discussion follows, that we favored you when previously, you were not even aware. And when was this? When we inspired your mother with that with which we inspired. إِذْ أَوْحَيْنَا إِذْ when أَوْحَيْنَا أَلْهَمْنَا we inspired إِلَىٰ أُمِّكْ to your mom, ma, that you ha, that which we inspired. So Allah, you know, says it in that context, like with a sense of ibham, there's a sense of ambiguity. O Musa, today you request, I've approved. Remember, there was a time you were a child, you were unaware, the surroundings around you were very, very challenging. And at that time, we favored you when it was that moment when we inspired your mom with what we inspired. So what did Allah inspire his mom with? Let's wait and see and understand the beauty of the Quran from there, inshallah. May Allah bless you all.